In this example, we have a baseball player, Ethan, hitting a ball 3 feet above the ground with an initial speed of 150 feet per second at an angle of 18 degrees with the horizontal. Will the ball clear a 20-foot wall that is 400 feet away? All right, so we have here a baseball field. The ball is being hit 3 feet above the ground. That's not going to be to scale. And we want to see if it's going to clear this 20-foot wall out here that might look like that. I'm sure Ethan would tell you that it will clear it, but let's see if it does mathematically. So remember, with parametrics, we're going to have two equations that give me the position of the ball at a certain time t. And remember, it gives me the horizontal position x, but it also gives me the vertical position y, both of those components. Okay, so we're asked, will the ball clear a 20-foot wall that is 400 feet away? That means what we have to do is find the height of the ball when it is 400 feet from the start, which means we need to find y when x equals 400. So let's write our parametric equations first. And again, we're just going to use those formulas. The horizontal will be x equals 150 cosine of the launch angle, 18 degrees, times t. And the vertical position would be given by y equals negative 16 t squared plus 150 sine of 18 degrees times t. And then we have an initial height plus 3. So again, first I need to find out how long it takes for the ball to reach the wall, first of all. So, and that'll give me the amount of the time t that the ball is at the wall, and then I can find the height from that. So I'm going to set 400. That's the horizontal distance from the start to the wall, equal to, that's my x value, 150 cosine of 18 degrees times t. And then solving for t, because I need to know at what time it reaches the wall, I would do 400 divided by 150 cosine of 18. And that's going to give me a time of about 2.804 seconds. And again, if you want the most accurate answer, store that in your calculator. And then to find the height or the vertical position of the ball at 2.804 seconds when it reaches the wall, which is 400 feet away, I'm just going to plug that t value into my y equation. So that's what that would look like, and that gives us, if you type that into your calculator, a value of about y equals 7.178 feet. Okay, so what that means is, no, the ball will not clear the fence. It will hit the fence 7.178 feet above the ground. So sorry, Ethan, you didn't hit a home run. All right, so that's the baseball problem here. As you continue to practice parametrics here and these word problems, these are great problems. You will see word problems that look like this. Again, you're just going to need those two formulas and then plug in what you know and then think about what you're trying to figure out. We will also do an example where wind resistance comes into play.